How did I shoot that? It's a Bridal editorial with Mariana Penilla. Let's see how I shot that today in the studio. Hello there, my name is Alex Silva, and welcome to a new studio. I did a bit of remodeling at home, so I'm trying a different setup. A few months ago, before the quarantine started, I shot a bridal editorial campaign for my friend, fashion designer Mariana Penilla. We did a similar campaign last year, so let me explain the whole process behind it. Mariana approached me for this shoot with a few clear requirements. She wanted to shoot in a studio with a seamless background, so the viewer only saw the bridal gowns without any distractions. Since the gowns are white, we needed a slightly darker, seamless background, and we agreed that a light gray would do fine. She also asked to emphasize the texture and embroidery work on the gowns. Finally, we needed two tall, thin models with features that help make contrast with the background and gowns. I don't have a studio, and some places already were restricting access to their facilities because of COVID-19. So we decided to use a portable studio. After considering a few options, we realized we could simply shoot at Mariana's store and shop. The models were two friends of mine, Gabby and Esme, who are experienced models and are great to work with. After a few tests, I decided to go with the one light setup using a Godox TT685 inside my trusty 90cm Octabox on top of my new boom arm light stand. I strongly recommend you to use a light stand like this, it's amazing! On the day of the shoot, the models went to do their hair and makeup, while Mary, Mariana's sister, and I installed the studio. We set the background support, lights, tripod, video camera, and we were ready. I started using just one light as mentioned before, in a setup similar to butterfly lighting, but the models didn't always turn towards the light. The angle of the light provided texture on the dresses, so we could see the embroidery details. I also decided to shoot with a knee-high angle, so the models and gowns would look more regal and important. In order to keep a low angle without breaking my back, my camera was on a monopod and I was sitting on the ground. The first portion of the shoot was done with my 35mm f1.4 lens, but then I moved farther away and switched to the 56mm f1.2 in order to compress the image a bit and gain some sharpness. For the second gown, I tried a different lighting setup, with the main light pointing downwards, so we got some reflection from the white floor, but still feathering light towards the dress. With this lighting, the model's face was a bit dark, so I added a second TT685 with a small softbox to camera left, lighting the model's face. We also needed a few images with both models together, so I went back to the 35mm lens and the light at a 45-degree angle towards the models. After I already had all the needed shoots, I decided to run a little experiment with my camera, shooting video at 120 frames per second, to start experimenting with slow motion video, as you can see now. I really like the end result, but this is still a test. Most of the post-processing was pretty simple, because we shot in a studio and the lighting conditions didn't change much. The adjustments were mostly in standardizing the image profile and white balance, then increasing the contrast and shadows, and decreasing the highlights. As you can see, my process is not super complex, but it makes my results predictable and repeatable. I make sure to define requirements, have a clear and thorough pre-production phase so the production and post stages run smoothly. In this case, one of the main advantages in order to create repeatable images was shooting in a studio where we could control the lighting, camera and model location, and we had a clear timetable. I really hope you found this video interesting, informative, but also entertaining. If that is the case, please press the like button. You can subscribe to the channel and share this video with your friends. But most of all, please remember to stay safe, keep learning, and keep creating. And I'll see you in the next video.